And what they fail to tell you sometimes is that although it's taken off your credit, you still need to pay it. Right? Like, it's not just going to disappear. Certain things will, like if it's in collections and it's been in collections for like 8 or 9 years, depending on what it is in collections, theoretically they have to take it off. Student loans, they're not taking that off. You know, medical bills, generally, you can probably try to settle, but they're not really going to take it off. But if you have, like, I don't know, a credit card that has been in collections for 7 years, well, once you make that payment, like, 6 months or 6 years and 8 months, now it starts that cycle all over again. So it's a hit or miss of what it can be that can take it off. But majority of the time that they're just eliminating things, they're eliminating anything that is causing your debt to income ratio to be high. And some things in that aspect are not in collections. So if they take off a credit card bill, $5,000, oh, it might be off, but you still owe it. And it may come back and hit you later on. And you're like, well, where did this come from? I thought it was taken care of. No, it was temporarily removed.
So how would we know those things, those items that's just temporarily removed?
So I would honestly say, like, when you pull your credit report, just see the last date of which you've interacted with that account in regards to making a payment, right? And if they call you and say, hey, is this Drea, I don't know your last name, hun, but if this is like, you know, Drea Smith, who's calling, right? And then they're like, oh, well, you have an account with, no, I don't, hang up the phone. Now, I'm not saying it's gonna work for everything, right? But the minute you admit that this is your account, now they can hold you accountable to it. Mm. Some things you may want to use as a settlement. And I know a lot of people say never settle because it lowers your credit score. Well, your credit score is already low. So if you settle and get it off, it gives you more time to build it up faster.
Mm-hmm. Mm. Okay.
So with settling, how does that work exactly? Say, okay, I have a debt of $4,000. They offer me $1,500. Pay out the $1,500. It lowers my score, but does it shows that it's paid and clear on my credit report? Like, how does that work?
So something that I recently learned is that you can ask them, you can negotiate your settling, basically. Okay. So if you have a $4,000 debt and they're like, okay, well, we'll take it for $1,500. And you're like, okay, great. You can then ask them, if I pay you $1,500, can you put it as paid in full? So now on your credit report, it shows that it's paid in full versus that it was settled. Hmm.
Okay, I didn't know that.
Paid in full is better on your credit than, you know, settled or collections or the grantor closed the account. So you just talk to them and ask them. Now, after you speak to them or when you're speaking to them, write down the person that you spoke to, the date, the time, because they're definitely going to have the recording of it, and ask them to send you a copy in the mail. So ask them to send you what you just discussed in the mail, and once you receive it, that's when you pay it. Because now you have a paper trail of stating, you said that right. $1,500
right.
is full.
Yeah, I had to, when I was going through purchasing my house, I had to get two things removed from my credit. So, but I paid in full. One was like $154. And then the other one was a dispute that I was going through with an old rental place. But it came off right away, and I had them send me a letter. Then I sent it to my financial person, and they made sure it got to the credit report to get it off of there as soon as possible. So I think my score went up from it, and I ended up having a better interest rate for my house too. So,
yeah, and so how long did it take you? 30 days, if that?
Less, because by getting that letter, they put it in right away. They sent it directly to the three credit bureaus.
Yeah.
So it might have took like a week after they got it and stuff to remove it, you know, because it says, hey, this is going to be removed. So.
Well, good for you.
Yeah.
Paid in Full was a good movie, by the way. That's been brought up multiple times in this conversation. Just want to put that out there.
Really?
So I saw you on your money tip Mondays, you know, you discussing about the 401k. Can you just elaborate a little more on that, and do you recommend a 403b?
So, okay, I think everyone needs to invest in their 401k, 403b, or if you're military, I think it's TSP, right? Mm-hmm. You need to invest in something, especially if your employer is matching what you're putting in. So basically the match is dating. Let's say you're making $60,000 a year. The company's going to match you up to 6%. Well, that means if you put in $3,600 for the year, they're putting in $3,600 for the year. Now, maybe in 1 year, it might not seem like a lot. It's only like $7,200. I mean, that's a good amount for me. But multiply that, you know, by like 5 years, you can either have $18,000 or $36,000. Well, I'm going to take the money, right? So I think at some point you need to. Now, if you cannot afford to put in the full match of what your company is offering, then maybe you start off with 3%. And then when you get your raise, instead of spending your raise money, you increase your 401k because you really cannot afford to not plan for your future. It's not like a double negative, but you really can't. Like, you have to plan for the future. I'm not fully knowledgeable of 403Bs, but those are for teachers and stuff. So I didn't really educate myself fully on those, to be honest.
I have a 403B.
Okay.
And I'm gonna be honest with you. I'm gonna be honest with the world. Only got it because the shorty that sold it to me was cute.
What?
But, like, you know, I get my monthly statements, right? So I'm looking at them. I don't know what the hell I'm looking at. I'm gonna be real. All I see is numbers.
Is so it
I
got a job or
through my it's not through my job per se. It's like outside contract, if you will.
Okay.
You know what I mean? So, you know, they'll set up shop and say, hey, you know, we're working with this school district. We're offering you this. You know what I mean? So it's not through my particular job. But with that being said, like I said, I'm looking at the numbers. So I don't know what those numbers mean. I don't know. I know I'm contributing X amount of dollars each check. You know, I call them, hey, how much I got in my account? Oh, you got this amount. Okay, no problem. Next week, next month, you'll have this amount. Okay. All I know is a decent amount in there.
Okay.
That's all I know. You know what I mean?
So I'm going to actually have to get back to you on that one.
I never even heard of a 403B before. I know the 401k.
Yeah, 403Bs are generally for like public schools or like tax exempt organizations, like nonprofits. Sometimes it's doctors, nurses, things of that sort. But I was under the impression that you can actually get it through the job. So this is something that you did outside of your employer.
Correct. It's through the employer, but not through the employer. You understand what I'm saying? It's not like, because we, like, through my job, I have my own separate retirement that's offered with my job.
Okay.
You know what I mean? But this is something that they only work, like, with the public schools, like you said. They, you know what I mean? They're outside source coming in.
Okay. Well, I'm going to take note on that one, and I will give you an answer.
I have another question.
I have an answer, hopefully. Hopefully it's not a 403Bs.
It's a 401k question. So me, I know, like, through previous jobs, I had to contribute to 401Ks. Mm-hmm. How do I find out that information? Because I don't know how that works. Like, because I no longer work for these companies.
Contact them.
So I contact the job?
Contact HR. HR has to still have all your records on file, even if they switch from Fidelity to Vanguard to whomever else, like, it'll still be on file. So I would just contact the corporation and ask to speak to HR. And you don't even have to necessarily give all your information. You can really just say, hey, you know, I was an employee there. I left my 401k there. Who's servicing us? And then you contact that organization, give them your, most likely your social, your dates of employment at the other location, and they should be able to pull it up.
I know when I quit my job, they reached out to me about my 401k, and they asked me, do I want to transfer to like another job, or do I want my money? And I just said, I want my money, and they just sent me a check in the mail. I didn't even reach out to them.
Yeah, that happens also. So they can automatically, like you said, transfer it to your new employer, so that way you don't get hit with any penalties. Or if you opened up your own personal like IRA account, they can transfer it into there as well.
Okay.
But definitely start with HR will definitely have to.
So what is your take on like money market accounts versus CD accounts?
Well, it depends on why you're doing it. So with CDs, it's kind of like a set it and forget it. And if you take any money out of it, you'll get penalized. Money market accounts, you can generally have to have a higher minimum balance to actually open the account. You have interest rates that are similar to a regular checking savings, and you can only withdraw from it 6 times out the month. So it really just depends on what you're looking to do with it.